Hello, BRG, and welcome to episode 3 of the Ragged Alliance cast. I'm Zenix1, BRG team leader and officer in Hope. Thank you to everyone that have been submitting photos, audio, and videos for the podcasts. Please like, subscribe, and share the YouTube channel to get the word out to everyone about the Ragged Alliance cast. We'll be posting a new episode every other Monday. Please speak to your guild officers or guild leader to have content you'd like to include in the podcast sent to me by the Friday before the next podcast. Complete MP4 videos with audio, or MP4 video and MP3 audio files are preferred. Let's start this episode with a video from BRG Resources. Please check out Hubris from Livin' La Vida Yoda on Twitch. You can also watch Hubie the Kid on YouTube or follow Hubris Plays on Twitter.
Territory Wars shout out.
The Direwolves have certainly been busy recently. Not only did they get their first batch of Wat Tambor shards from the Darkside Geonosian territory battle, but player Opius Sky had 428 banners, and Clad had a team defend 10 times in the last territory war. Congratulations, Direwolves! This past week, Big Red, GL of Hope, helped a neighbor's 4-year-old daughter possibly save her mother's life. He rushed over to assist with the mother who had a seizure. Her daughter was instructed to call 911 first, but Big Red's quick thinking and assistance saw the paramedics arrive and take the mom to the emergency room, where her husband soon followed. Thank you, Big Red, for watching out for your neighbor. Baltic Fleet officer NMRN's younger sister competed in her first international figure skating competition last week. She ice skated in Courchevel, France, in front of thousands of people at the age of 15. Mark Solo of Space Dragons and his wife are expecting their first child due on January 1st, 2020, and just found out they're having a girl. Congratulations to the new mom and dad. Congratulations to Doubledown of the Direwolves, who was promoted to BRG Recruitment Officer. If your guild has promoted someone and you'd like them mentioned, please send me a direct message in Discord and I'll make sure they're listed here.
Greetings to all my ragged allies. I've been watching these casts, and I decided I want to tell my story. My handle is Char Nimbus, which is the name of the first Force user I ever played in the Star Wars tabletop role-playing game. I'm a former member of the Guild Canadian Bacon, along with several of my allies in Gin and Juice, and I've been playing free-to-play since near the beginning. I remember when guilds first dropped into the game, and my early attempt at creating and running one. I didn't know enough at that time about how to recruit and manage participation levels. Our roster never hit 50, and there were only a few of us really participating. After several months, I found myself the leader of a decent starting level guild with too much deadweight to attract serious players near my level, but one that offered decent rewards for folks just starting out. I knew we'd created something that benefited lots of our members, but it wasn't sufficient to help me or my real-life friend Aldershot, who was my right-hand officer in our guild. So we stepped down and began searching for a more suitable home for ourselves. We landed in Canadian Bacon, a guild that had mastered the now laughable pit raid, and settled in for the long haul. A little over a year later, our founder and leader got frustrated at his guild's slow progress towards the heroic difficulty of the brand new tank raid, and absconded with not a word. We didn't let that stop us. Within the next few months, new leadership had sorted themselves out and we were beating the tank regularly. We settled into a routine and kept on plodding forward together. I think that routine was productive in its way, but we got trapped in a way of thinking that felt right, but led to a slow decline. I've seen it in Galaxy of Heroes and other games too, a live-and-let-live philosophy, marked by minimal communication for most members and contribution from each guildmate as they saw fit. There was a focus on loyalty to long-standing members with no emphasis on each member's responsibility to participate hard for their guildmates. We also never really adopted Discord as part of our standard operating procedure, despite Gil 118 making one and trying hard to push it. We'd bested the tank, but we never got past Tier 6 of the Sith Triumvirate. We also saw our Hoth territory battles performance peak, then begin a slow, steady decline. Territory wars launched, and it was many months before we even had our first win. In all our time, I think we won 3 or 4 out of many dozens of campaigns. There also began a slow exodus of longtime guildmates migrating to sunnier locales. One of those who left in the night was Talon Claw, who had always been one of our old faithfuls, and a heavy hitter at that. Aldershot and I began discussing another move ourselves, but I wanted to give it one last push to make Canadian bacon salty again. I began messaging officers, starting with Gil, with my ideas for how we could get better together, and joined the 3-member Discord. I knew the only way to save our guild was to correct our lack of communication and foster a culture of accountability towards one another as guildmates, and we needed to start recruiting. Next thing I knew, Aldershot and I were officers, and pushing for participation. It became clear quite quickly that there was more apathy than will to get better, to the point that we even had a belligerent member placing his easiest squads up front in territory wars, despite clear orders to the contrary. We got another 2 or 3 mates on the Discord server, but it felt like we were just spinning our wheels. It was about that point that Talon Claw walked back into our lives on the Discord server. He had found a growing alliance of guilds, which were recruiting folks like us who were feeling ragged from the grind. He'd missed us, and wanted to get the band back together, and saw a golden opportunity. The alliance was already in the process of merging a couple of other guilds into a new one called Gin and Juice. We officers discussed it between ourselves and decided that we'd take that plunge from the steady but comfortable decline that was Canadian Bacon into the uncertainty of this new adventure that we're all together on now. We opened the door for those who had shown initiative, who had wanted to put in the work and reach towards saltier bacon, and explained ourselves publicly before leaving the rest to do as they please. I sincerely hope they're still comfortable and getting all the enjoyment they can from this wonderful game. I remember the first several hours, nervously waiting for the changeover to be over. Not being sure if this new guild was everything we were told it would be, nor if we were up to par for their expectations. Then I got on the splash page on Discord and I got to read a little about the origins and philosophy of Boba's Ragged Guild Alliance. Dash assigned our roles, and passed us a round of younglings, I think, and we started making ourselves at home. Fast forward a few months, and here we are, progressing quickly with many old friends and dozens of new ones, all of us in it together, pushing hard to succeed with the knowledge that the only way we can master this galaxy of heroes is together. For myself, though, my Chewie, we're home moment came a few weeks ago, when Zinix1 unveiled all his hard work on these casts. Listening to our fearless leader, TK2618, describe his frustrations with his first guild and the philosophy that brought him to during the epoch of the Alliance. That participation and commitment are paramount over galactic power amassed by lazy play and cash. I really felt like the Force had led me to exactly where I was meant to be. Hats off to them for all their hard work, and thanks also to each and every one of you for the part you play in creating this space. It really means a lot to me. May the Force be with you all.
Thank you for watching the BRG Ragged Alliance cast. If you have suggestions for segments for the podcast or would like to contribute, please reach out to your guild officers or GL.